This is Ram Gopal, and I'm going to talk my experiences about work from home. Because of the COVID situation, now we have some experience, so let me share some of these points. First and foremost thing is we have to plan our work with a proper schedule and focus so that we pretend and feel that we are working from home but working for our office, right? So we have to prioritize things and remember that you have to complete the tasks on time. So you have to quit on time. You have to put yourself in the shoes that you don't want to take undue advantage. At the same time, set the boundaries so that you are able to finish the task. The second most important point is maintaining proper posture as well as professionalism in terms of communicating either on call or on video or on chat, so that we don't get complacent as well as we don't forget that it is work from home but not free from work, right? We equally have to handle our ergonomics based posture based disturbances sometimes that may affect us in terms of neck pain, back pain, or long hours of working on the system. So we have to efficiently create an environment where the chair, table and setup that we use at home is compatible with the way we are able to work efficiently like we are working in office. Another important point is handling the disturbances, because we are associated and surrounded by family members, siblings, kids. So we have to see that they understand our work from home concept as well as our plan of action, so that they also help us in increasing the efficiency of this system of work from home. Sometimes they also may need some advice because they may also be having classes and working from home. So we also have to help them. Last but not the least, we need to take care of our internet connectivity and bandwidth speed, because that's very important to efficiently contribute for this work from home process. So keep a sufficient backup for your Wi-Fi as well as a backup for your system, and see that your work from home concept actually helps your organization to get the best out of you. At the same time, you don't compromise on your health as well as your working environment. All the best.
Hello everyone, I am here to talk about work from home etiquettes. A couple of days back, I had posted an article on the very same topic, and I was pleasantly surprised by the number of likes and the comments that the article received. It only reinforced my belief in the topic, and given our current time and the scenario that we're all in, this is what our work is going to be. It is going to be work from home for some time now. So I think it's best to brace up ourselves and get ready for what we are, what we have to do for the next couple of weeks perhaps. So not getting into the detail of it, I have four takeaways in this video for you. The first being, dress professionally. Wearing pajamas and t-shirts is definitely not giving us the feel of being in office, but wearing a proper formal dress that we would otherwise wear to work definitely helps. It just helps you to dress for the moment, and that's the start of it. Second, set your table. Someone had told me that table is reflective of the state of mind. So however clean or however messy your table is, that is what your state of mind is going to be. So keep your table as organized as possible so that you can you can see through the day. Third, stick to your routine. Just because you don't have to take that cab and just because you don't have to catch that bus does not mean you get up at 8 in the morning and 8:30 you log in. So try to stick to the routine. It helps. It helps to set your entire body into the motion. Last but not the least is a task list. And as I say this, I really know how difficult it is to come up with a task list every day of the day when, you know, our managers are not looking at us. But it is that one key ingredient of making your day effective and productive. So if you want to make your day effective and productive as much as you want to, making a task list right at the first thing when you start your day is the only way. So those were my four takeaways for etiquettes at working from home. I hope all these 4 points helps you, and take care and stay safe. Thank you.